Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In this video, we're going to look at how Smoke can switch between different hard drives as its main media storage. Normally, your main storage for Smoke is set up during the initial installation, and the installer creates a folder on the hard drive called Autodesk Media Storage. Now, we all have our main set of storage, but you also have the ability to have multiple Autodesk Media Storage folders on different drives. This allows you to switch your media storage for different projects. So you can work on Project 1 with Drive A and Project 2 with Drive B for storage and performance reasons. As a practical example, you have your main media storage at your facility, but you want to take Smoke on location, but not with your main storage. So an alternative solution is to take another portable hard drive, and this can contain another Autodesk Media Storage folder. So let's set this up. The first part I want to show you is how to create a new Autodesk Media Storage folder. Firstly, Smoke should not be running. Also make sure that the hard drive you want to use as your portable storage is attached to the Mac. In the dock, open up Applications, go to the Autodesk folder, choose the Smoke folder, and finally choose the Utilities folder. Click the Smoke Setup application. This is a small application giving you access to the underlying settings of Smoke. I don't recommend playing around with these settings unless you are 100% sure what you need to do. To define the new media storage for Smoke, click the Media Storage tab and click Add to bring up a pop-up window. Creating a new media storage is a two-step process. Firstly, you choose where the media storage folder will be located. And secondly, you give the media storage a name, which is how Smoke will identify it. So click Select, and you will navigate through the Finder to the new hard drive. At the root of the hard drive, create a new folder and label it as Autodesk Media Storage. Select the new folder and click Choose to confirm your choice. So the file path that you see in the window is where Smoke will create the media cache when you choose to work with this drive. As a friendly tip, please don't use your system drive as your media storage. Rather use external fast storage for the best performance. The media storage name is what Smoke shows you when you choose the media storage in the Smoke startup screen. You can call it whatever you want, but please avoid illegal characters and stick with letters and numbers. Click OK, and the media storage list will be updated with your new entry. Click Apply to make sure the settings stick, and close the Smoke setup, and now you can launch Smoke. So here we have arrived at the project startup screen, and things are a little different. In the past, if you only had one set of storage attached to the system, the storage volume would normally be grayed out. Now, it is a pop-up button that allows you to choose between media storage volumes. Here you can see the new media storage I created earlier. If one of the drives is not attached to the system, the list will only display what is available. So going on location with the portable hard drive and nothing else, Smoke will only show you the drive's media storage as the available storage volume. To open a storage volume, select it in the list and press Open. Any existing projects using this media storage will now become available. You can now either create a new project or open an existing one. So here are some very important points to recap when you have multiple media storage volumes. Do not use your system disk as a media storage volume. Only use fast storage for optimized performance. If your drive is not connected or not functioning correctly, it will not appear in the storage volume list. You can only switch between media storage volumes in the Smoke startup screen. If you're in an open project, you cannot switch storage volumes from the preferences or Projects and User menu. The next point to mention is that a Smoke project is a combination of data files on your system disk as well as media on the media storage disk. Therefore, it is not possible to simply move hard drives between Smoke workstations. If you do this, the other Smoke will not recognize the drive as a storage volume, and this could lead to corruption. However, you can move media between systems, projects, and storage volumes using the Media Hub in Smoke. We'll have a look at this in our next video. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.